Allah the Almighty says in Surah At-Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 36, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Allah the Almighty mentioned in this ayah that ever since Allah created the heavens and the earth, the number of months are 12. The number of months are 12. إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا. 12 months. That is since He created السماوات والأرض. منها أربعة حرم. Out of them 4 months which are حرم. Ruler of haram, يعني sacred, which means that as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم explained and is also explained in the same ayah afterward when he said فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ, it is to emphasize the prohibition of committing sins, particularly during these sacred months. In the hadith which is collected by Imam al-Bukhari, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said the year consists of 12 months, 4 of are sacred, 3 consecutive, that is Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah and Al-Muharram, then ورجب مضر by itself which falls between Jumada and Sha'bah. This hadith is collected by Al-Imam Al-Bukhari. Allah the Almighty says in this ayah 36 of Surah At-Tawbah, ذلك الدين القيم, that is the upright religion. Those who follow the divine guidance in this ayah with respect to honoring and the, respecting the 4 sacred months are following the upright religion. Then شهر الله المحرم. In the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called المحرم, which is the first month of the Islamic calendar, as شهر الله. What is the meaning of شهر الله? Well, the 12 months are أشهر الله, all belong to Allah the Almighty. Rather, له الخلق والأمر. ألا له الخلق والأمر. The entire creation and the entire command belong only to Him. So whether it is Sha'ban, Ramadan, Dhul Hijjah, Dhul Qa'dah, or Al-Muharram, it is Shahrullah. But whenever Allah the Almighty chooses any of His creation to ascribe it to Himself, this is to honor the creation, that particular creature. When we say Baytullah, we all understand that Allah the Almighty has no house, and how can Allah, who is beyond boundaries and above all, can have a house that have boundaries? He doesn't stay in it, nor a piece of him is in it. Ma'ad Allah, Allah is above all of that. But to say Baytullah, it is sacred because Allah honored this house to ascribe it to Himself, Baytullah al-Haram. Similarly, every masjid, it is called Baytullah. But Baytullah al-Haram refers to the very first house of worship to be placed on earth, Al-Ka'bah, Baytullah al-Haram. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, أفضل الصيام بعد رمضان شهر الله المحرم, then we learn from this hadith, which is collected by Imam Muslim, two very important facts. Number one, Al-Muharram is a sacred month because of its name, it's sacred. Number two, its sacredness is emphasized and it is greater than the rest of the months because it is Shahrullah, is ascribed to Allah the Almighty, Shahrullah Al-Muharram. And also we learn that fasting during the month of Muharram from beginning to end as much as you can is highly recommended because the hadith says أَفْضَلُ الصِّيَامِ بَعْدَ رَمَضَانِ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ الْمُحَرَّمِ. The hadith doesn't explain how much fasting should be observed day in the month of Muharram, but as it has been narrated in many hadith by Aisha رضي الله عنها and others, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never fasted for a whole month other than the month of Ramadan. He used to fast a lot in Sha'ban, he used to fast a lot in Muharram, and according to the hadith, the most recommended fasting after fasting, the obligatory fasting during Ramadan, is during the month of Muharram. So you have the choice to fast every other day, or to fast Mondays and Thursdays. You've got 8 days during the month of Muharram, in addition to fasting on the 13th, 14th, and the 15th, which are known as the white days. We did earlier explain why were they called the white days, and not to forget on the 10th, the 10th of Muharram.